Hello and welcome to the review of Prince of Persia: The Two Thrones. It's a video game released in 2005 and is a third-person puzzle action platformer. Now the story is, right after Wario Within, you are returning from the Island of Time and you have used the secret ending. That's where the story starts. You have saved Kaelina and defeated the Haka. And you're coming back and you find your city in rubbles, in combat, in war. And your ship gets taken down and you get separated from you and Kaelina. Unfortunately, Kaelina has been knocked out cold and the enemies carry her to the Vizier. This is where the game starts. You journey to save Kaelina. This is a really minor spoiler, so I'll just say it. You reach Kaelina, but the Vizier's henchmen take you down and you witness Kaelina being killed. Now you should remember, Kaelina is the Empress of Time, so that means when she is killed by the Dagger of Time, her sands get released, and the Vizier, using these unreleased sands, hits himself and transforms into a more immortal being, and he believes that he is God. And now the story starts. Not, it doesn't actually start. Now the story continues, where you are hunting down the Vizier to kill him and end all this suffering, because all the Vizier's troops have been turned into sand creatures and they are terrorizing your citizens. So that's how it starts. The graphics have been improved from what I've written, a bit less choppy, but the choppiness is still there. Nevertheless, you know what graphics does, right? To show you what's going on. So it doesn't matter if it's choppy, because you can understand what's going on. Plus the transformations into the Dark Prince and all that, it was really nicely done. Great transformations, great scenes. It's all good. No need to complain about the graphics. The atmosphere is, you can see the kingdom in war. Everything is broken down. All the people are suffering. It gives you the feeling that you are within, indeed inside the Persia, right? The Prince of Persia. You are within the kingdom of Persia. Now the soundtrack. Unfortunately, they have gone away from metal. I really love the soundtrack from Wario Within, the metal music. But they have gone away and chosen some other style. It didn't really stick out to me, so I can't comment on the soundtrack. But man, Wario Within was better. Now you can interact with many things, ledgers, poles, columns, and there are some certain wall plates, those things, and curtains. There are many things you can interact with. They help you progress through the level. There's not much, but it's enough, and that's all good. The combat is the same as Wario Within. Although they have removed the beheading and cutting your opponent in half, those things, you can still perform those actions and kill the enemies, but you won't be able to witness them get, you know, torn apart. The combat is the same. Many people say the combat has been watered down, but not really. It's the same combat mechanics, just without the beheadings and gory stuff. The bosses are really interesting. For the first boss, I'm not gonna spoil anything, so for the first boss, it's really interesting how you defeat him. You use your quick time events ability to make it more versatile and more interesting, rather than just slash. There are some certain cutscenes you can interact with. So it's really interesting how you do that. And for the second boss, they have copied it from Shadi from Wario Within. The movesets, I'm talking about the movesets. They have copied them, but it's alright. It gets the job done and that's enough. And there's another boss that is really hard, and I like it for that. It was really hard. It made me take about 8 attempts until I eventually finished them. So those are really interesting. It's new. Nothing copied from Wario Within, nothing copied from the Sands of Time. It's new and that's great. The difficulty, I chose the hard difficulty, but I didn't face any troubles. Only for the third boss I faced troubles, but I believe easy also would have troubles fighting them. I had hard difficulty and I didn't face any problems. It was all easy. So you don't have to worry about that. Now, traversal mechanics is always, as usual, the same as Wario Within and the Sands of Time. You can run along walls, you can climb ledges, do parkour walls along poles, things. Just, it's great. It's just the same, but it's great. What do we have next? Collectibles. Does it? There are two collectibles. One, you have to collect sand points. With those points, you can unlock the artifacts. Now, I didn't try really hard. I just explored. If I found one, I used it. I collected it. And by the end of the game, I had more than enough to look at all the artworks. All the artworks were unlocked, so I didn't have any problems with, not having enough sand points. You will get enough sand points, no worries about that. Just collect them whenever you can. The other collectible is the health upgrades. As usual, from the Sands of Time, worry within the health upgrades. You can use them and upgrade your health. Unlike Worry Within, you will not unlock any secret ending if you don't find any find the sands of if you find the Sands of Time. What am I talking about? Unlike the previous game, you will not find any secret ending if you collect all the health upgrades. So you don't have to try really hard. Even if I didn't manage to collect all of them, I missed one. But it's no worries, it will all be the same deal. So you don't have to focus too hard on it. And finally, the pacing is the most important part. And the pacing, let's see, it's really well done. Okay, in the Sands of Time, it had terrible pacing. Worry Within, it had great pacing, but near the ending, it fumbled. But Two Thrones, it has full from beginning to end great pacing. There are cutscenes in between, there are events, there are bosses, there are many things, and there are even chariot rides. That's new, that's different. So the pacing also deserves a lot of points. And now, based on my points, you can decide. If you are a fan of, third person puzzle platformings, things like that, and combat, that's also still great. You'll love this game. If you're a fan of shooters, if you're a fan of shooters, you will not like it. But just based on my points, you can decide for yourself whether you like it or not. That'll be all. Enjoy the game if you want. See ya, and take care. Now, I spent some time experimenting with the controls,
what have I become? A
and
sand monster?
I've gotten used
Call
to
it what
it.
you will. Have been given the ability to destroy your enemies. Now use it.
What benefit is this? Even as I fight them, I grow weaker.
Kill them then. Let their lives replenish yours. It's good, is it not? Lead them into the light. Strike while they are blind.
I've gotten used to it, and we can defeat enemies with style. Watch this, I want to show you something. That didn't do it, right? That's one, and we've got one more. Get up, get up. I haven't got all day. Get up, get up. I'll show you something. Come on, it's not working. There we go. That's it. Didn't take it, right?